Good morning, babe. First night in my van. And do you know what day it is?
Christmas.
It's 6 months since you decided to have me as your girlfriend.
Oh, it's almost like Christmas now.
6 months of hell. I'm kidding. We slept the first night in my van.
Yeah, that was not so nice, really. We both had a terrible night's sleep. But it works awesome.
Yeah. I wonder if the bed is more soft on that side. Can you try to lay on the other side?
Babe, I'm not sure if I'm the right guy for deciding it.
Is it the same? Okay, but it looks cozy. I'm coming over. Bring in my coffee. Bye. Today it must be day, like day 30, I think. But I started with the interior yesterday, and a lot of things have actually happened, so I will show you a bit of it. It's a big mess at the moment, but you will still see. So the couch, I am just trying to figure out what kind of, you know, colors and stuff. But we got some curtains, we got a flower, we got a shelf, and here we also got a shelf with my beautiful golden wine glasses. Don't know what I will do about this big pot, if this one is gonna go up or another, like maybe another one of them, don't know yet. Over there, we got some cute lights. And lights over there. And then in the bathroom I sorted out some stuff for my product. I haven't put the toilet in yet though. And yeah, and as you saw, we slept here for the first night, and now I will start move in things in the shelves. So the biggest, like, the challenge at the moment is like where to put everything, so I don't know really how to, but as I did before, probably gonna move it around 1,000 times. But the thing that I realized is the small mattress that I have over these ones, the big ones when I'm sleeping, don't know where to put it. I thought I could have it here in the back, but I can't, it doesn't fit, and it just looks awful, and I just removed the whole couch or like the sitting space. So, don't know, it's in the front at the moment. I don't want to have to move it back and forth, but I guess I have to. I put all of the pillows and stuff up here, so that's good. But yeah, well, you have to live in it for a while before you actually realize what you want to do and where you want to keep all the stuff. So let's start moving into and put some stuff in the storage.
We'll be right back.
going shopping! Bought a battery charger, so I have the possibility to now connect my van to electricity because I couldn't do that before. So I got that and a cable and then loads of other stuff. I lost our basket. I wonder if it's this one. And then a lot of other things going down. So this is what I bought. We tried with Andrea's charger, but it doesn't take my battery bank. Cool. So we are installing a new alarm system in the van. And we have a camera up there. And it's following Andreas because he is hiding. Nice. Just a bit slow.
Okay, bro. Next one.
Dun, 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 dun. I love this, and then I can speak. Get out of my van! He speaks. Perfect. And then it actually calls me if there is a problem, which we have tried. So it's like alarming, low battery. And then it also calls me if I'm not turning it off. So the van is calling me. I love it. Now I can be safe. And I can also alarm it while I'm in the van. And it's also going to be sensors in every single door and motion detectors. And yeah, it's like all of it, everything you need, literally, which is amazing. So if I'm in the van or if I'm leaving the van, I'm always going to feel safe. And I love it. It's quite cool. If someone wants to know how my van looks like, I can just put the security camera up and say, like, this is my van. And it actually films all the way down. Look, so it's filming all the way down to the floor. Yay! And I can like put it up. Whee! Up in the roof. Love it! We live. Yes, we're live. We have a message, a statement, I don't know what to call it. My van is done.
Yes.
It's done. It's like, it's always not going to be completely done. It's always going to be like small tiny things that yes. I want to fix and buy and, you know, the never ending story.
But in general speaking, as whatever you have, a house, a car, a van, whatever, we are done.
Like, yeah.
As done as you can be.
Yeah, and we're super happy about that. And I would say the biggest change, I'm going to show you around a little bit about more specific about some things that we've done that I've got a lot of questions about. But I would say the biggest change in the van is actually that it feels so much bigger.
Mm-hmm.
Because of, first of all, yeah, of course, the windows, because I didn't have that before, as you know. But then you can actually walk through the whole van now. Before, when you open the back door, it was just like a massive bed, a massive storage space. And then when you walk in on side, you just had this tiny square that you could like turn around in and then say hello.
And that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
And now everything is so much bigger.
And I actually have more storage.
Yes, that's the funny part, that you have more storage.
Yeah.
You have a bigger bed. You have, yeah. It's a win-win.
I'm really, really happy. And also to say that we did go to the building store to buy material, but we actually didn't use it because we actually returned it. Because what we've been using is, of course, some of the parts from the old build, but then also most of it, I would say, is an old wardrobe.
Old wardrobes, yeah.
Yeah, not one, several. But so if you have like old things at home, it's really, really perfect to use. Do you want me to hold the camera?
No, it's fine.
it's perfect to use when you build a van like this, and it's actually really, really nice. And everything is so nice. I'm really, really happy.
Okay, let's have a show around.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so if we start here in the kitchen, so the kitchen is the same as before, but down here it's a big change. So now it's not just two big boxes or bottles or what do you call it, with water. It's actually, so the water tank, it's a bigger grey water tank. I only had 10 litres before, now I have 20. I have a shelf so I can actually put stuff in it. So that's really, really amazing. And we might also do, as you got babe in your van. We haven't decided that yet. If we're just going to do a hole in the ground so I can let the grey water out straight away if I want to or not. So that might happen. But otherwise, this is really, really nice. The shower and toilet got a door. It didn't have a door before, which means that I can hang stuff on the wall. Don't mind the cable that is for that's going to disappear, but it's for the alarm and the security camera. But this also turned out to a wardrobe, which is amazing, because why not use it in, you know, different and several smart ways. So absolutely love that. And then the fridge moved up, as you know. Oh yeah, I forgot this. Girls, you're gonna like this, but this is a shoebox that fits tons of shoes. It's a big mess, don't worry about that.
And it's also a seat.
It's also a seat, yeah. It is.
And you have a little shoebox in there as well.
Yes. And as you see here, this is an old wardrobe, this is an old wardrobe. The whole sides in here, this is all wardrobe space. So that is really, really nice. And I love this area because now I can fit my gas stove here. I couldn't do that before. It was a big, every time you open this door, the gas stove fell out. So that's amazing. My boyfriend loves popcorn, that's why we have plenty. these ones we had before, but they're just better and bigger right now. So I got clothes in this one and then...
And they stay open.
And they stay open. That was so annoying. I got them in my head every single time before. So that is that. And then we have the bed. So if I'm alone, I can actually sleep in the bed up just like it is, like a couch. I just remove this one, and this is 80 centimeters wide, so that's actually good for me. Or I can fold this one out all the way here, and it becomes a double bed, which is nice to sleep in, right?
Yes.
We've been staying in my van now for like a week because you don't have a van at the moment.
Because we're building mine.
Yeah. So this is amazing. And then underneath you do have storage as well. And these ones is for like campers and boats and all of it. It's amazing. So now it's open and then you do that and it's closed and it can't get up. Absolutely love it. And then... If you're more people that want to sit and have dinner, or if you just want to lay on one side, you can put this one out. I haven't fixed all of the pillows and stuff, so everything is a little bit temporary. But then you have, which is going to be nice with the same colors and stuff, no, it's just blanket. But then you have an L-sit couch. So either you can sit like this, or you can lay here and you can watch a beautiful scenery. Can you hear that I'm selling this? It's not for sale. Or you can actually sit like this. And I'm building two tables that you can hang on the windows. So you can actually sit here and eat and have your glass of wine here. It's gonna be really nice. So, yeah. So to go a little bit more into detail with this one. So this is for a bed. It's a rib for bed. So you have one, it's laying like this. So this is the pull out. Part, and this is the one that is always here, and then you did this one and it works kind of good sometimes.
It works good for me 100% of the times, and for you 10% of the times. You just calculate that into something, but yeah, it works.
Yeah, it works. It's really, really nice. So table-wise, because this is actually based on the stories I've done on Instagram, I got a lot of questions about the table, so I thought I'd show you more about it. So either you just have it like this, like a beautiful bench.
As a storage.
And storage, because you have storage all. Tips for you guys, use the doors for storage as well. I've done that in every single one of them. But then you can put all of the dinner up here, sitting in the couch, and you can just move it closer. If you want to sit even closer, you just fold the couch out, you pull this one, and you can sit closer to the table. Perfect. And you can also put stuff here, because we put this one here, so that is really, really nice. So this is like a huge, big office, and I absolutely love it. I actually did a lot of work hours here the other day, and it was just so amazing that I could just spread out and have everything. So this one is connected with, I don't know what you call this in English.
Extender, something like that.
Yeah. Something with these ones. So they have to be stacked towards a wall. So that's why we built the shelf up here. And also on this side. So on this side is actually connected to a wall here. But then Andreas came with a super smart idea that, well, let's make a shelf that is floating as well. So yeah, so this one is not connected to the table.
Yeah, so you can see the table that it actually goes underneath there. Yeah. And that means that you got a secret storage right there.
It's not so secret anymore when you show it on YouTube.
We still got the alarm.
Yeah. And when you're driving, I forgot these two times, we just have a screw in here that we just pull up, and then you can't move the table actually, which is really, really nice. So yeah, piece of cake, easy peasy, everything went really, really smoothly and just in a week.
Yeah, right. No.
Why not? You can also use it like this.
Yeah, we've been having some movie nights, and we're gonna buy a projector for you as well. So
yeah,
this is gonna be where you sit and
up there. That's just temporary, just testing out. But then you're gonna be able to pull down the screen, and you're gonna have a projector, and so you have like this big cinema.
Yeah, so you're gonna have a big screen.
And I also bought a big popcorn here. Ball,
ah,
so we can
great.
Put popcorns in my bed.
Yay!
You're so happy about it. And then we also did, we don't have to go in there, but in the front we did a shelf in the top. So that's where I storage like stuff that I barely use, like tent and sleeping bags and all of that, but it's still good storage. And then it's storage underneath the whole couch. And also with a huge, that we just bought yesterday, a huge battery charger. Because before, on rainy days, it was a little bit on the edge with the battery, and it's been on the edge in Sweden, first time. Which means that if we don't have enough sun here, my battery is going really, really low. I never had a problem in Spain, because I have a lot of battery, but here it's been not so good. So we bought that. So now I can connect it to electricity as well. I couldn't do that before, actually. And now you can actually enter and exit the van from the back doors, which you couldn't do before.
And the most important thing is that you can fit a motorbike inside. You haven't even mentioned that, babe.
No, it actually destroys the interior.
No, it just makes it so much better. But yeah, so that's worst case scenario. We can have one bike in here, and we can have one bike in my van as well.
It's amazing. So now, I am gonna do the last part of the interior, the alarm things, and then I think we're gonna enjoy moving out here tonight. What
Sounds
do you think?
Sounds great, babe.
Yeah.
I need a chill night.
Yeah, we need some popcorn and a good movie, and we're gonna try it out with your projector to see that it works.
Bring it on, babe.
Okay, bye guys.
Bye. Mm-hmm.